Hey YouTube, it's your man Shox, and today I have some awesome news for you. I don't know if this is becoming something like a trend or so, but I just found out about another developing team trying to bring back Paragon. You probably heard of many teams trying to provide us a Paragon-like experience somewhat in some game which is supposed to be like a Paragon 2 already, but this one is quite interesting. There's actually very less information on this, but after watching this video you will know everything important about Primex. Sit on the ground, she just wanna go live. She don't want no love, she just wanna go live. The team all behind this calls themselves Team Sealeaf, and I actually have no idea if I pronounced that correctly. I hope so. I think they are mostly from Korea, but you can find them on Discord and on Instagram. There they call themselves Primex Official. I will put both links in the video description so you can take a look at it yourself. They first leaked information very recently. I think their first Instagram post was uploaded on 25th of October, but since then they provided some decent footage. So they are obviously trying to bring back a Paragon like experience and game, but I actually don't know if they are producing one game or at least say one map, or if they're gonna put several maps into the game, because you can see footage of different types of maps. Sometimes the map they show looks like Monolith, sometimes it looks like the Legacy map, and again other times it looks like something completely new. So right now I really can't tell you if they are gonna do a mashup of these different types and in the end it is going to be a really huge map, or if they're just gonna do different maps. But I think they want to do a really huge map, probably even bigger than the Legacy one, because on one post they said that they increased the range of abilities and auto attacks, at least for range auto attacks, I think, drastically. I think there is a video where Rampage throws his rock miles away, but that's just my opinion. And you can even see Twinblast climbing on a tree, so they actually want to try implementing the terrain a little bit more, not like just in Paragon where you could jump over some walls if you played a character with some enhanced mobility. But here even Twinblast, who has only his dash, can't even climb on a tree, and just look how tall it is. I mean, like, if you now try to watch the whole map, you can't even do it. So I'm not sure if this is just some sort of a test area for them to try out some hero reworks or something like that, or if this is actually going to be the map, because in another clip you can see pretty much the Monolith layout of the map with Gideon running around and throwing some rocks on enemies. And then there's some other footage where they want to show a rework of the Shadow Pets. So yes, they want to bring back Shadow Pets. I don't know how much they are going to rework them, but in the post they've said that they would have redone them. They haven't shown us any real gameplay or player versus player combat scenes. I think what they've shown us so far is all just player versus bots, but it looks smooth. It looks really, really smooth. The abilities seem like they are on point, and the auto attacks, it looks really, really smooth. The way the character runs around and stuff, there's always some sort of impact when they hit an enemy or shoot. Murdoch's basics seem like they would do a ton of damage this way. And when Cervic is using his ult, they already did his ult and it seems to function. There's some sort of huge impact when he's throwing enemies away or swinging his hammer. And Twinblast's ult seems to be devastating as well. He has not that machine gun from Monolith, he has this rocket launcher from earlier where he shoots multiple rockets fast after another, but doesn't shoot a beam like he used to do on Monolith later on. But yeah, the attacks and animations seem to be very smooth. It looks all very good. They've also shown some travel mode animations, which I don't really know what I think about this, if this is going to be cool or if it's going to be really bad. Maybe they could balance it and then it is cool. I just want to get surprised with it, and so I'm just looking forward to seeing more footage of them. What I'm really excited for is they are actually implementing the hero voice lines. You can see Gideon throwing his rock and using his ult on some bots, and in the background every time he does something, one of his hero voice lines is played. Every time the character throws a basic attack, he does something like a oof or ah, which makes the whole situation just way more realistic. They've already done the same thing for Twinblast, so when he is throwing a grenade, he says something like get some, or when he uses his ultimate, he says there's a bug on you. I know all these lines. These are actually the hero voice lines Epic wanted to implement into the game when Paragon still lasted. I'm using them as well in my cinematic videos and my new Vault gameplay edits. I think it just really enhances the whole situation when you hear your heroes talking specifically to the situation. I think they want to publish an alpha in 2020. I don't know if it's going to be early 2020 or late 2020,
they just said 2020. That's all I know. So this is the most important information I could get. I really hope you enjoyed that summary. Check their links yourself to maybe get some more information. If you enjoyed watching this video and found it helpful and I could provide you some information you didn't know, please leave a like, and I would really appreciate it if you subscribe to the channel. I'm going to upload a summary of all games and attempts to create a new Paragon 2 or a similar gaming experience in near future, because there's many new information recently and I just wanted to make it a little bit more understandable so that you guys are all on track properly. I also mentioned Fault in this video, so if you want to get more information on Fault or want to watch some great gameplay of it, I'll put the links to Strange Meta Studios, the team behind Fault, in the description as well, and my last Fault video. That should be it for now. I'm out, so just like always, thank you for watching and have a beautiful day.